Now, Katharine, it's often been said of you that you have a genius for knowing what people want to wear. But what kind of people would want to wear these clothes?
Well, quite ordinary people, I think.
Ordinary people?
Yes, ordinary solicitors, businessmen, secretaries. If they don't get the original, they'll probably get the copy.
I mean, will we actually see people walking down Oxford Street in those sort of clothes?
I don't look terribly happy about the prospect. Oxford Street is probably not where most of my customers prefer to walk, but maybe crossing the road.
Sloane Square, then?
Well, I don't even know about Sloane Square. You see them in Milan or Paris, New York, Rio, Tokyo, Frankfurt.
The girl with that lace top, would she, well, what would she wear? Would she go to a wedding in that, or...?
No, what? Just wear it out shopping, really.
Oh, really?
Yes, I mean, they're quite handy. I think they look very feminine, very romantic. And if you're feeling a bit under the weather, throw it on and you look fab.
You're just off to see Princess Diana. You wouldn't expect her to wear either of those outfits, would you?
Well, I think she'd look rather good in the one on the left, actually, the lace outfit. I'd prefer to see her in that than quite a few of the other things that she chooses.
Well, you might prefer it because you designed it, but you wouldn't seriously expect her to go on the next royal tour.
Well, what you're looking at, you must remember, is clothes that are going to be relevant in 6 months. You can't expect them to be relevant now because they're designed to be the things that people will feel like wearing in 6 months. And
yes,
gradually, you know, the street level of fashion moves around, and 6 months, these are going to be very relevant.
Now, fashion is said to reflect, and I suspect you agree with this, to reflect society. It moves with the way we move. So what kind of society is this lot reflecting?
Well, I think the girl in the black is wearing basically a man's jacket. And I think that this is reflecting maybe the liberation of women, the fact that women are taking on men's jobs, that the roles are less defined, that women are getting much more powerful, and yet still retaining their, you know, their femininity, their flirtatiousness. They don't have to be as rigidly hidebound by kind of social conventions of behaviour, really, as men.
What about the fella? He looks a bit awesome to me. I mean, it's getting close
like
to army uniforms
awesome.
And jack boots and things.
Well, it's just the colour. I think people like to wear a uniform, makes them feel important.
Really?
Yes.
So that is, you see, for men, a serious trend for 85, isn't
it? Oh, I think so. I think there's a lot of action men around.
I mean, how will all this be translated to the fairly cheap shops, fashion shops of Oxford Street? How, in a phrase, would you say, is the style going to appear in those shops?
I think you'll see the colour first, because that's the easiest thing. And I think that the colour, this military green, is a very new colour for the season, and violet's popped up. Violet and lace has popped up right in everybody's collections.
And the question that men always ask, skirt length, up, down?
All over the place, really. I think it's simply what you feel like. I mean, you can wear two at once. Like, the girl in the violet's wearing a long handkerchief point skirt and she's got a fairly short skirt over the top of it. It's really what you feel like and what you feel confident in. You can wear any length and it'll be fine as long as you feel fine.
And finally, what you're wearing yourself, is that going to be fairly typical?
Well, this is actually something that's in the shops now. Yes, I think so. I think there's a return towards more kind of dressy, less scruffy clothes, and I hope that it reflects the mood. It seems to be quite popular. It's photographed a lot anyway.
Katharine, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.